All right.
I think we have approximately 9 minutes before Shalva comes home with the kids. So let's dive right in. First mistake that people make, chalky protein shakes. You don't have to have chalky protein shakes. Easy way to fix that, add some oats. Protein powder is pretty disgusting unless you're my four-year-old who likes to put a scoop in and...
Perfect. All right, now we'll put one more look.
Okay. Pretty much lick the protein powder off and have it all over his face. It's more hilarious than he realizes. Add oats. Number two, a stalled blender. Really, if you're using any blender, it doesn't need to be a Vitamix, Nutribullet, a Ninja. Protein powders have a way of, well, they make blenders stall. Everything kind of sticks together and you'll get a blade that's just spinning. How do you fix that? First of all, when you're freestyling, when you're building your protein shake just from whatever's in the fridge and you're not following a recipe, use what we like to call the wiggle test. Basically, you should have enough liquid where the frozen stuff like your ice, your frozen bananas, frozen strawberries, blueberries, they wiggle. They kind of move a little. But there shouldn't be too much wiggle room. So if it doesn't wiggle at all, it means you don't have enough liquid. If it wiggles too much, if it's splashing all over the place, if the frozen stuff is able to move more than a centimeter or so, you need to add more frozen stuff. The wiggle test. Silly way of saying, you have to mind the ratio, a 50-50 ratio of liquid to frozen stuff. And that's gonna keep everything, even if you like super duper thick protein shakes, 50-50 ratio is what you're going for. Pretty much any protein shake that you make, you can find success using a cup of liquid and a cup of frozen. So a cup of ice, a cup of frozen bananas. If it's too liquidy, stop right away. Adding ice or adding frozen strawberries later after you've blended for 30 seconds or 60 seconds, it doesn't turn out well. If you notice right away that it's gonna be too thin, if it's sloshing around way too much, if it is pretty much done blending after 5 seconds, stop. Add frozen stuff. That you want to use a slow ramp. So you're going to ramp up from the lowest speed your blender can go to the highest speed it can go. And you want it to go slow so that the blade, it keeps holding on to the ingredients. You want it to kind of not spin so fast that it just starts spinning against nothing and everything just stays there. You want it to hold on to what you're blending. So there's some feel to it. It's a bit of an art. Go slow and feel. And if you feel it to kind of start losing its feel of the ingredients, go back, slow down a little bit. And you may have to stop and give it a shake and start over all the way at variable speed one, the lowest speed it can go, and slowly ramp up. Keep the blade grabbing the ingredients. Liquids first. Add your milk of choice first, your water, whatever you're adding to your protein shake, pour it in first. It's gonna help you use the wiggle test, know the ratio, but also the liquid at the bottom is gonna help keep the blade connected, attached, grabbing to all the protein shake ingredients so you don't have those air bubbles. I'm just realizing now that we've done a ton of videos on green juice and we've done videos on soups and ice creams and all sorts of fun stuff that you can make in your Vitamix or really any blender. And in our newsletter, we've talked about making protein shakes all the time. We make them for dinner sometimes with pretzels and queso, or for a snack with a movie and popcorn. We don't really have any videos on protein shakes. So it's good to be doing this, to finally be talking about protein shakes, something that I guess I kind of took for granted that it's not really all that hard, but the more I thought about it, and it's fairly complicated and there's a lot to know and a lot of mistakes to avoid. Okay, back to the mistakes. If your protein shake is ugly, it may be because you mixed complementary colors. So blue and yellow makes green. If you mix green with another complementary color, if you mix green with purple, too much of that is gonna make a brown smoothie. Yes, you can add some greens to your protein shake, but you can't add too much. Add a little bit of spinach to your strawberry banana protein shake, and it'll still be pretty much red. You can sneak a little spinach or even a little kale in a mixed berry, sort of a purple protein shake, but not too much. Otherwise, it'll be brown. I think we're on mistake number four. If your protein shakes taste gross, the simple solution is just to add fewer ingredients. Less is more. If your protein shake tastes watery, add some frozen ingredients, especially frozen bananas. That's gonna make your protein shake creamy. Frozen mango is really good too, but be a little careful because citrus really only works with a few types of protein shakes. Mango with peanut butter, not so great. Also, to add creaminess, if you can't have frozen banana, frozen squash, or same thing with avocado, frozen avocado. We like to eat our avocados fresh. They're delicious and they're expensive, so to freeze them and you get it. Mistake number six, protein shakes shouldn't give you digestive issues, but sometimes they do. It's usually because the protein powders are pretty processed. So a couple things you can do here. You can make protein shakes without protein powder. You can also take a break. Making a protein shake without protein powder doesn't need to be the way you do it forever. It can just be kind of an experiment. You can also switch sources of protein. I got started on this whole journey with egg white protein. Bought egg whites, put them in my protein shakes. They were pasteurized, so safe to eat and you can't really taste them. Maybe add some seeds, chia seed, flax seed. Those are gonna give you some of that dietary fiber. It's gonna help with any digestive issues that you have with making protein shakes. Number eight, powders are not necessary. We talked about this a second ago, but there's protein in oats and greens and seeds and fruit. If you do decide to make a protein shake without protein powder, you should make it sweet. They're better sweet, fruit is sweet, but protein shakes are better with very sweet. Don't add sugar to your protein shakes, you probably know this, but there's things that you can use to make it sweet if your protein powder is not sweet, or if you're not using protein powder. You can use dates, agave is fine, stevia, but one that's really cool and surprisingly makes stuff sweet, it's like a faux sweetener, is cinnamon. You can add cinnamon to pretty much any protein shake you make. It's gonna make it taste better and make it taste sweeter. And the last mistake with making protein shakes, especially with protein powder, vanilla protein powder is really the only flavor that you should ever have. It is the most flexible and you can make it chocolate flavor with some cocoa powder. Use vanilla. Now, this is a good time to tell you, if you're liking this video and you like what we're doing here, you're liking the vibe, you can subscribe to our channel to get more videos about protein shakes and smoothies and lifestyle and recipes and demos and or not. Sometimes people don't have a go-to protein shake that they make every single time. They're winging it every time. They're throwing stuff in. Must-go smoothies and must-go shakes, when you just throw stuff in, is great. It's great for getting rid of stuff. But you should have a go-to protein shake that you make every single time. But if you want to explore and you want to venture out, stick with one of these tried and true formulas. There are seven of them. Number one, vanilla. How boring to make a vanilla protein shake? Yes. However, vanilla protein shakes become cake batter shakes by adding a lot of vanilla and more oats. And just the name of it makes it taste like cake. It becomes an apple pie protein shake when you add apples and cinnamon. Vanilla protein shake becomes pumpkin pie by adding some pumpkin. It becomes peach pie by adding peach. It's pretty much pie. Vanilla protein shake equals pie. Number two, peanut butter vanilla. It's like a Girl Scout cookie. So this is your vanilla protein shake, but adding peanut butter and probably some cinnamon. The simplicity, just the peanut butter and vanilla. Three, add some cocoa powder to your vanilla peanut butter protein shake to make a chocolate peanut butter banana protein shake. The best. That's pretty much our go-to. Now let's say you don't like banana, you can't eat banana. I have two for you. Peanut butter and jelly. This one impresses everyone. They love it so much. For a ton of people, this is their go-to protein shake. It's your standard protein shake, no banana and mixed berries. So something red and something blue. It's peanut butter jelly, it's the best. Now's a good time to say, instead of trying to list all of the ingredients for all of these protein shake recipes in this video, I'm gonna put links to all of them. It'll be in the description. Go there to find recipes for all of these, or just wing it. If you can kind of get the essence of it, you should be able to freestyle these. The fifth sort of protein shake, another one that's no banana, is a cherry chocolate. This is the standard formula. You have your liquids to solids, and then cocoa powder and frozen cherries. Gonna be kind of brownish black with a hint of red. Number six and number seven, we're gonna go fast. Blueberry protein shake. This is pretty much blueberry with banana. And number seven, strawberry banana. This is a really popular one. You can't go wrong with strawberry banana. And of course, like I said, frozen banana is gonna bring a creaminess to your smoothies. I remember when all I made in my blender was protein shake. And I was like, why would I make anything else? But green juice really opened up my world into like being able to feel energized and feel good without drinking coffee. And if you're interested in protein shakes and you're like, oh, all I make is protein shakes, consider this video about green juice. You can make green juice, whole food green juice, full of fiber and nutrients. It's gonna make you feel amazing. This video right here. And thanks so much for watching. And we'll see you guys in the next one.